Hey toy fans, Aaron here. Tonight I'm going to be taking a look at the 6-inch Black Series Admiral Piett. Now this is a shared online exclusive between various sites like Entertainment Earth, Big Bad Toy Store, and DorksideToys.com and so on. But this was released around the beginning of September 2018. So just in case you're watching this in the future and wanting to know, but let's head to that table and check this one out.
Taking a look first at the packaging, this is the Phase 3 line of the Black Series that gets you the red and black box. Star Wars Black Series logo on top. Through the window, you do see the figure with the included accessory. And along the bottom, you got a nice looking image of Admiral Piett along with his name to the side. And on the side of the packaging, just his name here. There is no number since this is an exclusive. And on the back side, everything you've come to love and know, you got a larger artwork image on the back of the box, along with a brief description about Admiral Piett and how he got his promotion. And now taking a look at the figure out of the packaging. Overall, it's a pretty decent looking figure. You know, for the most part, this is a figure we've already received. Much of this has been used from Grand Moff Tarkin, which is quite all right because it's an Imperial officer. They all kind of look the same. So for Hasbro to go in and use the same parts, it's certainly to be expected. Going in on the head area, obviously, this is a new sculpt here. As far as the resemblance goes, I am mixed on this one. I think from some angles, it does look like Admiral Piett, or at least there's a resemblance. And from other angles, it just feels like it misses the mark. Hasbro is using that new photorealistic face painting technology on this figure, so things really are looking pretty good as far as the paint applications go. The sculpting to the hat is looking very good. Nice touch of silver painting up on the top center of that hat. As far as that hat, it does slide on and off pretty easily. So no problems with that. So without that hat on, of course, it basically is just revealing more forehead and more hair. Decent sculpt going on there. Getting to the midsection of the figure, there is some variance here for what we got from Grand Moff Tarkin, and that difference is in the torso area. Some of the subtle differences within the torso area is the wrinkling of the sculpt that they use for the fabric, but the most noticeable thing, of course, and as it should be, Admiral Piett here only has 3 command code sticks. One on his right side, 2 on his left, where Tarkin, of course, had 4. So that's accurate. Good attention to detail there. And then, obviously, the painting is different for his little ranking badge. For the most part, that painting on the reds and blues is looking pretty good. Slightly a little bit lower on the mark than it should be. That's kind of really only noticeable when you're going in so close with the camera, though. Otherwise, though, the arms on this figure, and from what I can tell, his right hand is a reuse of Grand Moff Tarkin, except in this case, the hand is molded in the black plastic since he's wearing black gloves, where Tarkin was just the flesh-toned hands. His left hand, though, is a different sculpt from Tarkin. As far as I can tell, that is a different sculpt. Kind of interesting that they chose to change that. Otherwise, though, through the belt area, that, of course, is the same as we had on Tarkin, as is the lower half of his overcoat. Still nice painting for that belt, though, with that silver on the buckle. The little dot of silver off to the side of that. And that black painting for the belt is looking pretty good. Through the leg area, once again, as I've already mentioned a few times, this is the exact same as Tarkin. And once again, I don't mind. It's the Imperial Navy. They're wearing the same thing. I will say, though, one thing that I'm noticing, at least on my figure, is that the pant legs seem to be 2 different colors. His left leg, or the right as you're looking at it, seems to have a little bit more green coloring to that gray. Otherwise, though, for the boot area, things are looking pretty good. Like I said, nothing we haven't seen before. A little bit of strap detailing along the top back side of the boot. Got some wrinkles down there towards the ankle area. Otherwise, they're pretty nice, shiny black boots. As far as the articulation of this figure, interestingly, they chose to stick with the older version of the neck articulation, the neck and head. So, of course, you still get your 360 movement. You get just a little bit side to side and just a little bit of up and down movement. I'm just a little bit surprised that since they were making a new torso for this figure that they wouldn't have gone in and just used the new articulation system within that neck area. As for the shoulders, of course, they spin a good 360 degrees on each one. And then you're going to be able to raise them up just above 90 degrees there. At the elbow area, of course, it's going to go straight out. And then you're going to get your 90 degree bend in there. Both wrists do turn 360 degrees, and then each wrist also has that side-to-side movement. You're getting a little bit more range on his right wrist than you are on that left one. And that's just because of the way that coat sticks out over the wrist. As for the waist area, pretty good 360 degree turn there, and you get just a tiny amount of crunching forward and back. As for the leg area, you're going to get your splits like so. You get the legs coming out about forward this far. Of course, that little lower part of the coat does hinder that movement. And then you get your legs going back that far. At the top of the thigh, you got that joint right about here. It's hard to see, but you're going to be able to twist those thighs. And then the knees are, of course, double jointed. So you get a pretty good range of motion with that. At the foot area, You got a little bit for forward movement of the foot, but you got pretty good range going back. And then, of course, at the top of that ankle, that foot is going to twist all the way around. As far as accessories, well, he's got his hat, which I've already talked about, so there's one. But next up, he does come with a blaster. Never saw him use it in the movie, but you still get one here. Decent sculpt to it. Nothing overwhelming, but you certainly have some lines of detail in there. A little scope on top. As you can see, no special weathering or anything to it. It fits pretty well in his right hand, and he does have that index finger to slide into the trigger area. Obviously, no holster on this figure, so you really have nowhere to keep this blaster if you don't want to display him with it in his hand. So overall, this is a good-looking figure. While much of the figure itself isn't new, but the parts that need to be, especially that head sculpt and through the torso area, it's got it where it counts. Still a good sculpt. And obviously, that face printing technology does not give you much, if anything, to complain about. And as far as the rest of the figure being a reuse of one that we've already received, I certainly don't mind because that's the nature of an Imperial officer. They're all dressed the same, they look the same, so certainly the toys might as well look the same also.
And so that wraps up this look at the 6-inch Black Series Admiral Piett. I'd love to know what your thoughts are on this figure in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.